Yeah. All right, we're live.
We are gathered here today for an evisceration. I don't like doing these. It adds kind of a negative image to the community, you know, and we don't really need that. But in certain situations, certain motherfuckers need to be aired out. And today, we're talking about Raqib Marvelous. You might not know who he is because, you know,
what the fuck does he do?
Who exactly?
Yeah, who is he?
Yeah, what do you do?
What does he do? Can anybody tell me what Raqib does in this room?
Talk about dick all day, basically.
Basically.
On Twitter.
Yeah.
That's basically all he does. But on the low, he's fucking manipulating people.
Exactly.
I didn't even know this shit. I didn't really know it. I knew something. I knew something was wrong.
Yeah.
But I didn't know it was this fucked up. Raqib is using this man. He's fucking been using him.
And
this man, Raqib, owes him how much? How much money does he owe?
$40,000.
$40,000.
His ass from being homeless multiple fucking times.
So we are already 1 minute into the video, and you now know Raqib owes him $40,000. Everything from this point forward, keep that in mind.
That's the fucking bottom line.
$40,000. Hold that.
Okay?
Yeah.
Because it's fine, you know? Kobe's helped us all out in this room. Everybody, right?
Everybody.
But he's helped Raqib for fucking crazy shit.
Extreme amounts.
For extreme amounts. And then fucked him over. Using his mental state.
And me
Kobe's not good right now.
He's not good.
And Raqib is fucking using him.
Listen, we all go through traumatic breakups. We all know what it feels like. You're not in a healthy state of mind at that point. It's painful. You don't make the best decisions. Sometimes you wonder if the world's against you. How dare you use religion and helping people, generosity, charity, benefit, to manipulate someone into taking their money, using their kindness, and then fucking them up.
And this little fucker as well, he even knew about everything that was going on in my life recently with just my family, how my mom's been recently emotionally.
And he aired that shit out on Twitter. He fucking put that shit on Twitter.
That was personal.
Tweet longer.
Mm-hmm.
He put for what? He tried to use it against them. How the fuck you use somebody's personal problems against them after they've helped you out so much? How much were you paying in that house?
Dude, I was honestly the reason why that house even became a thing because.
Was it because of him?
Because I had the proof of income. So apparently I didn't even talk to this dude yesterday. So I can't record calls or anything like that because that is illegal. So I didn't want to push past boundaries or anything. But even yesterday, this man called me and he was telling me that, yeah, I'm pretty sure I talked to you yesterday about photoshopping documents because I had no proof of income. You were the only person who had proof of income.
You want to photoshop documents, you little bitch?
Bro, you
want to put niggas name on four signatures, you little bitch?
Huh? I just remembered something. This man, Raqib, so Kobe's PayPal, that shit says YouTube on it. When you get paid from it. He was saying that he was using some of that shit to show that he was making some money and he was passing it off as YouTube paying
him. What the fuck?
That's what I'm saying. This
I just
dropped this shit. I just dropped this shit on them right now. I just remembered that shit. That edible's kicking in, nigga. Holy shit.
You idiot. Yo.
I don't give a fuck. What's
it's
the problem?
Out.
We're in Vegas.
It's coming
There's
out.
No problem with
it's
it. Just
out.
Like
Raqib,
we're trying to fuck him up like that. See, let's move on.
Let's get another one. Let's get another time you lied, you little bitch. What about the time that you came up to niggas and this was right after, by the way, I remember that time you asked Sully and Kobe for $1,500 each. So that was,
fucking Super Mario Maker.
You made him pay $1,500 for Super Mario Maker early, two days early.
And he never even gave it to me.
No.
Shit. Wasn't he a Techno Buffalo and he got that game and he just sold it to you for $3,000? Was that
basically,
it?
Yeah.
Fuck!
Keep living.
Yo, but that man's been helping you out. How come he didn't just hook you up for free?
Exactly.
What the fuck? What kind
and
of shit?
Recently, this is what really made me start to realize because honestly, I've had too many, like I said, issues to deal with besides this shit. And I always gave him the benefit of the doubt. I was really stupid. But recently, he's been trying to throw me under the bus and kick me out of a place that I basically made happen for him so that he wouldn't be fucking homeless. So he was trying to say that he made this place that I basically signed a lease for a year ago. Trying to say that it was a mortgage the entire time. Trying to make me look stupid in front of so many people. And Duncan Needeep was one of the witnesses.
Mm-hmm. You can ask him.
And I just found out recently because he's been trying to exert power. He's been trying to say, you know, smoking marijuana and all that stuff, which I've been using because been so stressed. I've had really, really bad anxiety that I've needed it to eat and sleep.
Trust me, it's crazy. This man's not in a good fucking place right now.
You already know one situation it's that happened crazy. Recently when yeah. I didn't have it. I was having so many bad yeah. nightmares.
He's having panic attacks and shit. Like, he's fucked up, and Raqib is using that mental state to literally to make him his puppet.
To basically have control. To have control over this place, basically say it's his house, and then exert power over multiple people
this
in
man
the
helped
house.
Him out with the
and
lease.
And then I just found out yesterday because I called the landlord. I called the landlord a couple days ago to talk to him because none of this shit added up.
Nope.
How can he change a mortgage, or how can he change a lease to a mortgage
without my permission?
The man
said the rent turned into a fucking mortgage. The man said he got an 800 grand mortgage, hasn't paid my boy back yet. What the fuck?
It was a year-long mortgage, which just fucking ended.
And how many more houses? How many more houses is that man trying to get?
He was talking, saying that he's going to try and get
four houses.
Before even trying to pay me back.
40 grand.
So I called the landlord. I called the landlord on this shit. And he had no idea. He was like, no, this shit's been month to month. It's never
you know
been
damn
a mortgage.
Well, you
this
can't
man
get four
knew
houses.
The entire
we're
time that
documents.
Wasn't a mortgage. No, no, but he's been, I don't know if he actually did or not, but he called the sheriff basically saying, oh yeah, I have a mortgage and all this stuff. And this man's
are
trying
you actually
to smoke
doubting
marijuana.
Whether he did or not? Of course he didn't fucking call the sheriff. Of course he didn't fucking call the sheriff. He didn't do all the other shit that he did.
Exactly.
Yo, this is
he's
fucked
been
up,
lying
bro.
The entire time.
Oh, by the
this
way,
is fucked up. I can't believe this shit, man. What the
by the way, let's talk about something else too. It's not even just us in this room right now that are acknowledging that Raqib has lied to us, manipulated us, used us, but a lot of other people that you might be familiar with also agree with that statement. For example, you know, Shofu, Trap God, Yon Shofu, you know, all that,
trap
Bill Gates, all that, Trap Catcher.
Trap Catcher, oh shit.
We
what the
actually
fuck is going
have,
on?
I'm getting messages.
You got
right?
it?
Yo,
he's getting more. More,
he's,
more fuel.
He's,
I'm getting more.
More fuel.
Well, he popped an edible too.
Yeah.
I mean, like, we're fucked up. Oh shit.
Yes, yes, indeed.
I'm just letting you know. Plus, that also brings up an important point when you were fucked up on the stairs and you fucking aired that shit out on Twitter.
He did.
What's the problem with being lit?
He already.
It's
he
Vegas.
Already,
we're not doing anything
knew.
Wrong.
By the way, this is Shofu. Shofu right here. Look at this. Trap catch him. You see that? Niggas know. Niggas know about Raqib.
We're aware.
Shofu, I know you never fuck with Raqib from day one, nigga. Trust me.
Stay woke. We're all woke.
So, well, what the fuck is the problem?
So like I was saying, basically recently this man's been trying to say that I don't have any say on this place that I basically made possible for him whatsoever because he knew the situation that I was in mentally that I wasn't going to try and dig too much into it because I gave him the benefit of the doubt for so many things because these guys constantly told me before, they were like, I really don't believe you should be fucking with this nigga.
No!
And how many people said that shit? How many people said that shit?
Everyone!
Times,
oh my God.
So many times that they've been trying to tell me. And you know, I just stood up for him because he always told me about how depressed he was, the multiple times that he was suicidal and all this shit. Like multiple times, I stood up for him. And at the moment that I actually am dealing with something, he tries to throw me under the bus.
Man, fuck. For the longest time, I've just tried to like avoid this fact. Because before, Kobe didn't understand, man. Kobe didn't see that side, but like,
yeah.
you know, eventually shit's gonna blow up in your face.
Yeah, exactly.
You should have known that this was gonna happen.
Even tell him about what happened with how he was trying to get extra money out of me.
Yo, so initially when Raqib asked Kobe for 15K, he was hitting me up about it. He was like, yo, you think it's a good idea?
Give me 15K?
You think Kobe's gonna give me 15K? Yo, what if I lay it out like this? What if I write a contract? He wrote a contract. He said, if you don't pay me by this date, we don't really remember the date. I don't know. It was like, I don't remember what the fuck it was.
Yeah.
Anyway, but the contract, you know, he signed it. He put, if I don't pay you back by this date, prosecute me to the fullest extent of the fucking law.
Raqib, you know damn well that contract is up, nigga.
You know it's real. You know we're not lying about that shit. Why haven't you paid him back and you talking up a big game about three, four houses? What the fuck, bro?
And why is he trying to throw me under the bus?
And why is he
throwing me under
the bus?
He already knew.
After all the help you gave him.
Because I called him out multiple times. I called him out for him lying to me about someone having PTSD. Because he wanted me to believe that she was so crazy that anything she said completely invalidated.
No.
So, but she was one of the
no.
people that he was fucking lying about the most. And then he even, I found out recently too, he constantly says nigger all the time when I'm not around.
Like, it was direct racist.
Yes, he
racist ass.
It. I
said,
saw it. I saw it.
Calling people nigger? Huh?
Nigger.
Come call me a nigger. Huh? How about that?
Oh,
listen, we're at Evo. He's here right now. We're not
he's
gonna do anything.
He's here right now.
We're not gonna do anything. We're not gonna hurt him.
Fuck.
This is not a physical, this is not a violent threat. This is not something where we're gonna cause physical harm. But I'm just saying, we're at Evo. Come call me a nigger, bitch.
call me that.
Holy
come.
Shit.
Please. I want him to.
Well, let me ask
I ain't gonna do shit.
I'm not even a gangster. I'm a fucking nerd. And I'm saying that.
And right before this video happened, he actually messaged me. He said, is Etika firm on making a video? I've been trying really hard at getting my life back together, man.
Show it. That's a message right there.
Right here. You can't see it. We tried.
No. You're about to see it right now. You see that?
Oh, shit. Okay.
See that?
There you go. You can kind of see it a little bit. So we're not fucking around. That's
Raqib. Yeah, we're telling the truth. That's Raqib.
All right? And you know exactly the struggle we both went through. So he's trying to guilt trip me because me and him used to talk about this shit a lot. Because he was in a fucked up place. I was in a fucked up place. Yeah. So we were talking about that shit. But he took it a whole different way. That man was talking about some really fucked up shit that he was trying to do to get out of that hole. That man was desperate. And like at the end, he was the one to help him out of that.
Yeah.
That's what, you know, me.
We all said, like, yo, Raqib, he gives me a funny vibe. I don't know, man.
I told him initially, I was like, 15K, man, that's a lot. I don't know, man.
Yeah.
And, you know, Kobe was like, yeah, I'll do it because he's generous and he actually cares.
You know what you told me? Like, you told me at one point that I feel like God is watching.
That's what he's saying. God, yeah.
Kobe
That's
told me God would That's want what... me to help him. And it was like, that broke my heart because it's like, somebody like him, this is my fucking nigga, you know?
Yeah,
this nigga helped me so much, man. I'm telling you, this fucking channel wouldn't be where it is right now. You wouldn't be watching me right now if it wasn't for this nigga, you know? Like, I'm just being real right now, bro.
It's
like,
the same shit,
this
same
nigga
shit.
Helped me, bro. He saved me. Thanks to me. Thanks to this
nigga. This
man,
is our nigga right
I'm here.
Yo.
And you know, like, crazy. I fucking love this nigga. And it's like, fucking Raqib just pulls it out of me, bro. He pulls the fucking worst thing out of me. And I swear to God, bro, I'm not gonna hurt you if I see you at Evo, but I'm gonna let you know that what you did isn't cool, bro.
And it's just like,
this is fucked up, man.
He's literally known, he's known my entire situation. Fuck, about my family manipulating me and all the abuse that she's put, well, my mom has put my sisters through, and then even what I went through when I was younger. And then just to find out that he's been the same. He's been providing comfort in those areas, but then throughout these years, he's been doing the exact same thing that they were doing to me.
Fuck.
Trying to act like he was family. And you know, he was someone that I honestly looked up to for a while. That's why I wanted to help him out so much, because I thought
fuck?
He was a good-hearted person as well. But then to find him starting to throw me under the bus recently with so many different things.
He charged him for the bathroom. That man couldn't use the he needed that bathroom right next to his room that should have been included in the rent.
So,
how the fuck you charge a premium for the bathroom?
He was trying to say that bathroom wasn't even mine.
That's fucking crazy. How you charge somebody for a fucking bathroom? I've never heard that shit before. That's fucking crazy.
Yeah, trying to overcharge me and everything. But anyways, it's just, there's so many things that have been just not adding up whatsoever. And I've had witnesses, people saying that they've seen him lie to me straight to my face about this mortgage and how it wasn't a lease at all whatsoever. And then all of a sudden now he's switching it from it was a mortgage the entire time to then, oh yeah, I switched it to a mortgage in February. And then all of a sudden when I call the landlord, this dude's like, he has no fucking idea what he's even talking about whatsoever. He's like, no, this thing has been month to month. The lease literally just ended this last month.
Raqib didn't think that this man would do it. Cause Kobe's not the type to, you know, be checking and shit and trying to discover something, right? But man, something was really fucking fishy about that mortgage thing. Like, how the fuck are you gonna bring that up
to me about it?
Yeah, exactly. He said that, and we were like, you know, it was at E3 when he told us that shit. It was me,
exactly.
Duncan, Barrel, you, and we were all talking, and he randomly brings up the fucking mortgage, talking
and how
a big
he's
game.
He's gonna get like four mortgages.
Yeah, and he was like, yeah, I'm gonna get three more houses. He was like talking up a big game. I know how he gets when he's talking up a big game.
Yeah,
he's like
he
looking down
up.
And like doing that shit, you know? Especially
like
in front of Duncan. He was trying to fucking just talk big, cause there was no talk of no fucking mortgage before then. It was just because Duncan was right there.
Yeah.
It's one of those things.
He just brags all the time to make himself look better.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, that's how he built up his career.
Because
he was telling me, what about the
had,
resume? What about the resume?
Not just the resume. His Twitter followers, they're all fake.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to bring up.
Wow.
You know,
yeah.
You look in the camera. He deleted his Twitter. But
he deleted his Twitter.
He deleted his Twitter because he realized this man was going to call him out on all the stuff that I've been talking about, too.
Yo, how'd you get that many followers, man?
Yeah, tell us about those. I'll tell you. Actually, I can tell them.
All right.
He told me.
Let him know.
Me one time, the best way to increase your social media following on Twitter is to go follow for follow. That way, you gain them, and when you don't want to look like you're a follow-hungry whore, you unfollow. It makes it easier for you, right?
Whoa.
You fake bitch, that's why you can't even get any likes on your posts.
That's crazy, you're shallow.
Fake bitch.
Fuck. And that's, you know, that's what it is, man. And it's like, and then he also tried to tell, you know, like Kobe that he was able to change the lease and get an $800,000 mortgage just because the landlord is a fan of this man and Raqib.
Yeah, so
what the really, fuck kind of story is Raqib, that?
So he told me in the beginning too that I was the reason I was the reason why they got that lease so easily of my proof of income, because they didn't have proof of income. And I talked to him yesterday too, because all of a sudden now he seemed to all of a sudden realize or remember everything that happened instead of lying to me saying that it was a mortgage the entire time, trying to take advantage of my mental state. So then he's like, no, I talked to you even before. I was like, I don't have proof of income with me and someone else as well. So we had to Photoshop documents to make it seem like we actually had proof of income.
Biggest Photoshop documents, bro?
Basically allegedly committing fraud.
That's crazy.
Committing fraud.
And committing fraud.
Megan Butcher can kind of testament to that too.
Mm-hmm. She tweeted a lot as well.
She tweeted like this man was trying to conspire to kill his own mother.
She lived
murder his mother.
She lived that shit in was the on same Twitter. House as everyone else. She lived there.
Yeah, she said he was deceiving. What else did he say? Didn't he say something about?
Wasn't he trying to actually? He was sexually make moves on.
He was trying to smash
when she was with
her boyfriend in the house in the fucking same room. What the fuck?
Yeah.
And she can attest to that shit.
She was constantly telling us too that, he was constantly telling me that he had like kissed her and all this stuff. All
what
kinds
the fuck?
Of different things. Like saying that he was actually like having something with her. And there have been multiple people
I remember
who told
that
me
shit.
Too. There were multiple people too who told
I remember
me
that shit.
That there
he
was,
kept talking
that
about that
he
shit.
Said that she was trying to make moves with him as well. And when we actually tell her, she's like, what the fuck? Like, I would never do any shit with this little nigga whatsoever at all.
Fuck.
Ever. And then he even lied about her having PTSD.
It wasn't the only lied. Girl he tried to do that shit to either. What about, Lady Sadie?
You have
that
pictures
shit on the,
of that.
I have pictures on that shit.
You have pictures
yo,
of
I have,
that.
I have the tweets. More trust, evidence. I have the fucking tweets.
More evidence.
This is not defamation. This shit is all 100% real. This is 100% real. Yeah.
You got it on you?
And then, let's talk about Glitch X City too, because this needs to go a little bit further.
Shit.
Because Glitch, you posted on Twitter something publicly for everybody to see that Kobe apparently was being abusive and
aggressive
when niggas were getting high when they were smoking.
I wasn't even getting high. That's the thing.
I was there. So what happened was Kobe was sitting there. You know, he was having a good time. He had drink. And she was like, it looked like she was taking a picture of him, right? So he was sitting there and she was standing. And so since Kobe was like, what the fuck? He's like, you taking a picture? So he like tried to grab the phone.
Yeah.
And you know, he was
she
fucked up.
So
she jerked so fast that, you know, his instant impulse was like, oh shit, you know?
I ended up grabbing her arm instead of the phone to see what was actually going on.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. And but then he let go. And even she even said that in the tweet. It was like, he calmed down right
yeah,
after.
Yeah, she said he calmed down.
She
so,
said
I mean,
it.
Why
like,
are you
why,
going
why,
to say
why even tweet
it was something? It wasn't a crime.
She was trying to get, because she was saying multiple times that she was uncomfortable or whatever with people like having marijuana and all that stuff. So she was trying to use that against me so that then she would have some leverage or whatever to say that, oh yeah, I'm aggressive or whatever with marijuana, when it wasn't even related to that whatsoever. It was actually me drinking. But still, there was anything that was inappropriate about it whatsoever from what I was told. And even when I talked to her too, I asked her because Raqib was trying to say, yeah, you grabbed her ass. Like, you were trying to like actually be super aggressive. Wait, what? Oh shit. Wait, did you find it?
No, I didn't find that. I found something else when he was saying, if we put the Sun and Moon ROMs and leak them through Adly.
Oh yeah,
revenue.
You'd be mad.
Show that shit.
Shit, really? I mean, whatever,
yeah,
whatever is on here. I don't know.
Raqib, you're going to you're getting real kind of like slimy with the shit too. So we have some stuff on you too, Raqib.
I mean, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Like, let's take a look at that. So you want to be a Nintendo brand ambassador still, bro?
Hey, go ahead and just go read.
Who cares? They're not even.
You want to leak ROMs? You want to leak ROMs?
Oh shit.
Okay.
They can't see it. Go ahead and read off everything.
So you know what? This is where we're going to approach this from this point forward. I don't want to hear anything about this nigga anymore. Don't want to talk about him. I don't want to see shit about him. If you follow him, unfollow.
Delete.
Delete this nigga.
Block him.
If you're a fan of him, be a fan if you want to. You're probably not a fan because all of his fans are fake. But if you are associated with him, block him. I don't want him to exist. It's over for this nigga. Eviscerate.